I fear no game. But that thing, it scares me. Hold on just a minute. For the last couple of generations, when you talk about the Call of Duty series,
always two there are.
There is the Black Ops series developed by Treyarch, which has always had this beautifully documented configuration files with all the options available and with a range of things to easily customize. And then there's the Modern Warfare type of game developed by a bunch of studios that have configuration files that just look like this. Now, take a wild guess on which side the free-to-play Battle Royale Warzone falls on. Yep, it's one of those games. I'm LowSpecAlex, welcome to the show, brought to you by Raycon. Warzone is technically attached to the Modern Warfare Remake Thing series, and it has brought me so much pain. Raven Software, Infinite Ward, or whoever is responsible for this game went through the work of obfuscating the configuration file as much as possible, to make life difficult for snoopers and custom config file enthusiasts alike, which makes it almost impossible for me to do anything at all with them. But I was determined to be the one to figure it out. I had heard just how many people wanted this game low spec'd. It is the mission of this channel to show that people with all sorts of PCs are gamers. I rose up to the challenge, and after many afternoons of tremendous sleepless efforts, I got nothing. I got nowhere. I'm not joking, I lost sleep over this thing. But then, something happened, something I had missed. I got a ray of light, a sense of hope. Somewhere inside my galaxy brain, something got revealed in my unparalleled, unchallenged, technical genius. Someone else figured it out for me. A year ago. So, it's low spec time. Okay, so there's this video by ChatC, which incredibly enough got less than 20,000 views, and this either made an interesting discovery, or is sharing an already known interesting discovery. In this video, ChatC offers a bunch of things. One of them is an extensive configuration file, that as far as I've been able to experiment, most of it does nothing. Except for this line. You can find this line in your configuration file in the documents folder, where the first number controls the LOD draw distance of the game. But for those unfamiliar with the terminology, most games use a system of level of detail, or LOD, where after a certain distance from the camera, the 3D models use less detailed versions in order to save on performance. Now, if you set this value to 0.05, the distance is set very close, and so all game models suddenly look like this. This is amazing. The game used to do this accidentally on PlayStation, sometimes due to a bug, but with this knowledge, you can force it to happen whenever you want to and sacrifice model detail for performance. The second interesting thing is this line in the configuration file, which controls the texture filtering and, when set to this other value, disables texture filtering completely. Texture filtering is an umbrella of techniques used by the engine to smooth out textures, and when you disable it, the textures look tremendously pixelated. Oh yeah. This filtering is particularly noticeable in the textures used for fog, clouds, or splashes of water. The more traditional PC gamers might reach this point and add this to their list of things to try and insult me over with comments, but we know better. This has to be worth it, right? I tested this on a mini computer with a laptop Ryzen APU with integrated graphics. You might want to keep an eye on this cool little box because I'm working on something interesting with it that might make it in a future video. Less than 35% of you seem to be subscribed, so this is a good opportunity to do so if you want to catch that video when it's out. Now, my objective here was at least to have over unusable 30fps on the most taxing areas of the map. I ran all my tests while streaming on Twitch and relying on your input when picking areas that are supposed to work as a stress test, and the results were fascinating. Since integrated GPUs use RAM as VRAM, more than 8 gigs of RAM were needed, sadly, as this game will crash on anything else. And this config could not help with that. However, in terms of GPU usage, this provided enough overhead for this integrated GPU to do just fine. In fact, the low LODs were only noticeable when getting very close to other players. Ah! Well, look at the players! Yeah, that's nice. Or when looking at certain guns or props very close, some of which will constantly struggle to keep that certain LOD level. Whoa! This is glorious! But technically, it did not affect the playability of the game, even while using vehicles, and it sure did not stop me from sucking at this game as usual. Eagled Eye viewers might have noticed that this is indeed the same Ryzen APU on the amazing handheld gaming PC from my last video, the Aya Neo, meaning that this makes it potentially the only handheld version of the game I currently know of. And you thought Apex Legends on a Switch was something. I do wish I could play this portably without bothering other people with the sound coming from my speakers. Oh, it's Raycon. Raycon is disrupting the electronic industry by designing premium wireless audio for half the price without compromise. I have one, I bought one for my girlfriend, and I bought one for my dad. And since Raycon offers their wireless earbuds in a range of fun colors and patterns, with a variety of fit options and no dangling wires or stems, I managed to find a model that each one of them would love. The company was co-founded by Ray J, which is definitely a person I have heard of before.
Huh.
And endorsed by celebrities like Snoop Dogg.
Wait, isn't this like a meme?
With a 45-day free return policy, 6 hours of playtime, and seamless Bluetooth pairing, and a more compact design, Raycon wireless earbuds are the best way to bring your favorite content with you, wherever you go. Click the link in the description or go to buyraycon.com/lowspecgamer for the 15% off your Raycon purchase.